Hello everyone, welcome back to the video tutorial series of the web development. I am your instructor Varshata. Let's start our lecture series. Now topics to be covered in this lecture, that is PHP function, PHP browser control and PHP browser detection. Okay, now let's see it one by one. First of all, PHP function. So what is PHP functions? As we have seen in last lecture, we have learned about the string function. Okay, we have learned the string reverse, string position, then word count, then length of the how to count the length of the string. So that is what a inbuilt string function is available. Now if you want to create the user defined function, then also it is possible in PHP. Now let's see why function is useful. A function is a block of code written in a program to perform some specific task. We can relate the function in a programs to employees in an office in a real life for a better understanding of how functions can work. For example, suppose a boss wants his employee to calculate the annual budget. Okay, so how this will process complete? How this process will complete? The employee will take the information about the statistics from the boss and performs the calculation and calculate the budget and shows the result to his boss. So in this situation, we require the function. Okay, so function works in a similar manner, that they take the information as a parameter and executes a block of the statement or perform the operation on his parameters and returns the result. So here, thus employee will take the parameters from the boss and the whatever the parameter provided by the boss, according to that employee will work on it and it will give the result to the boss. So same way, function will work, function will take the argument and it will reply accordingly. Now PHP provides basically two types of function. As I told you that we have seen the basic inbuilt function in the last lecture, that is a string functions. There are so many other inbuilt function is available. Now next is user defined function. So apart from the built-in function, PHP allows to define the user defined function. That means you can define the custom functions according to your requirement. So basically two types, built-in function and user-defined function. Now, what is the use of the function? So it provides the reusability. So code reusability is provided. You can use the same function again and again. You don't have to define the code for same thing again and again. Then easier error detection. You can detect the error easily. Then easily maintain. Okay, suppose you want to print the hello world 100 times, then it is very difficult. But if you will take one looping statement, for example for loop, and just iterate it for 100 times, and you can display the print state hello world, that is a statement that going to be displayed 100 times. So it is easy to maintain. Okay, so these are the reasons why we use the functions. Now creating the functions. So while creating a user defined function, we need to keep a few things in mind, which are any name ending with an open and close parenthesis is function. Okay, so any name that is ending with open and close parenthesis, that is defined as a function. A function name always begin with the keyword function. Okay, so compulsory you have to define this function as a keyword, then only it will work as a function. To call a function, we just need to write its name followed by the parenthesis. Okay, so suppose you have declared one function, that is say hello. Okay, say hello function. Say hello is the name of your function. So if you want to call it after defining, you just have to write that particular name and you have to write the open and close parenthesis. A function name cannot start with a number. It can start with the alphabet or the underscore. A function name is not case sensitive. Now here you can see this function is as a keyword, and here it is your function name followed by the open and close parenthesis, and in between this curly braces you have to write your code. So now let's see the example. Here function say hello, open and close parenthesis is there, so it means it is a function, and here you have to write the function as a keyword. Then echo hello PHP function. Okay, so this is what one function. Now how to call? You just have to write the name of the function with its parenthesis. So it will work as a function. It will give the output as a hello PHP function. Now, next is a PHP function arguments. You can pass the information in PHP functions through the argument which is separated by the comma. Okay, numbers of way, call by value, default value arguments, call by reference also, when then variable length argument you can provide. Now, here you can see the function username is a dollar name. Here, echo hello dollar name. So, whatever the argument you are going to pass, that will be display hello Vimal, hello John, etc. Now, next, you can pass the two argument also. So, echo hello dollar name, you are dollar age year old. Okay, so I am passing two argument Vimal 29. So, it will print hello Vimal, you are 29 years old. So, like this way, you can pass the multiple arguments in the function. Now, also you can also define the default argument in the PHP function. Okay, so if you will not provide argument, then it will work according to default argument. So here function, I have given the name as a default argument, dollar name is a call to Bob. Okay, so this is what a default argument. So here it will display hello Bob. So here I have defined Rajesh, I am passing this Rajesh value, so it will display hello Rajesh. But in second thing, I am not defining any argument in this, so it will display hello Bob. Okay, so like this way default argument will work. Now next is returning value. Okay, so function can return the value also. So here function cube dollar n, you can just define return n into n. So it will return the cube of the anything that you are going to pass. So cube of 3 is cube of 3. So here whenever you are calling this function, it will pass 3 argument and it will return 3 into 3 into 3. That is, it will return 27. Got it? Now let's see practical related to this. Okay. Now define the function function, function as a keyword, name of the function, say hello, then okay, define echo hello, hello all. Okay, so it is going to display hello all when I am going to call this function, say hello. Got it? Now just save this file and execute this. Our file name is a function. Okay, it will display hello. Now let's pass the argument to it. Okay, suppose I am passing here. Dollar name. Okay, and here I am passing hello Bob. Okay, so here just write dollar name. Got it? Now just save this spectacle and execute this, refresh this page. So it will print hello Bob. Got it? Now pass two argument. Dollar H, so hello, you are year old. Got it? Sorry, I have a comma. Now pass two argument here. Suppose I am writing 30. Just save it and refresh this page. So hello Bob, you are 30 years old. So like this way you can pass the two argument or single argument. Now let's start with the default argument. So here, just I am providing dollar name is equal to, suppose I am defining it as a Bob. Okay, now here hello, just I have provide dollar name. Okay, now here I am not providing anything, so it will display it as a. Now next say hello and define another name. Suppose I am defining Alice. Okay, just save this spectacle and refresh this page. So it will display hello Bob and hello Alice. we are not passing anything to the function, so it will display it as a hello verb. And when we are passing ally, so it will display it as a hello allies. Okay. Now let's see how functions return the value. Suppose I am defining the function cube and I am passing $n. Okay, then just define it, return $n into $n into $n. Just store the semicolon. Now here, delete it, echo cube of 5 is, okay, just give space and here define cube and pass the value, suppose 5. The semicolon it and execute the spectacle. Refresh this page. So you will get the cube of 5 is 125. Okay, now let's continue with our next topic. Now next topic is browser control, PHP browser control and PHP browser detection that we are going to see. Now PHP can control the various features of the browser. This important as often there is a need to reload the same page or redirecting the user to the another page, etc. So for this type of features, we can control the browser in PHP. Some of the features are accessed by controlling the information sent, but in the HTTP header to the browser, this use the header command. Okay, how it will use, you have to define this header command in which you have to define the location. Okay, then after the colon you have to define the specific file from where you want to redirect. So here I have defined index.php, so whenever you are going to execute the spectacle, it will directly redirect you to index.php. Now suppose you have written like this way, header location colon http colon www.google.com. So whenever you are executing this PHP file, it will execute, it will redirecting you the www.google.com. And you can also control the caching using the some header command. So header cache control, that is no cache. So like this way you can control the browser in PHP. Now next is browser detections. Okay, so the range of the device with browser is increasing, so it's becoming more important to know which browser and other details you are dealing with. Okay, so if you want to know which browser you are using, you can write like this way, $browserID is equal, this is a user defined variable, you can write anything over here, but here is equal to $_server, in which you have to write HTTP user agent. So whenever you are writing this code, it will display the output like this. Okay, so it will give the browser related informations as you. So this is the typical response, you will get the similar response to this. Okay, now here the $browserID, that is a user defined variable, and here you can see this is what one type of associative array. Now got it where associative array is used? So here $server, in which we can write this string index HTTP user agent. But suppose this string index is something 105 or anything is written for this index, are you able to remember that particular index for each and every features? No. Okay, so that in PHP that feature is provided that you can use the string index of the associative array. So there are so many other facilities also available in this PHP that you can use to access such type of information. Now let's see how we can access this information and how we can redirect the page in PHP. Okay, so here write it down. Suppose I am writing, first of all I want to redirect the page. So header, what you have to write? Location. Okay, then you have to do the semicolon, colon. Then suppose you want to redirect on a Google, so HTTP colon / www.google.com. Okay, so like this way you can redirect the page when you are going to open this browserdetection.php. So let's execute this. So execute this file, browserdetection.php. So here you can see it is opening the Google page. Okay, so like this way you can redirect the page in PHP, and if you want to redirect in any local file, then also you can do. So let's check it. Suppose I want to redirect the page that is available in, that is stored in the same same practical folder. Suppose I am writing it. One file is there, php in html.html. This file is saved in my PC in this practical. Okay, now just save it and execute this. Okay, so it is opening this HTML file. Hello students, this message is from the server side. This practical we have done when we have started the PHP practical. Okay, so like this way you can redirect the page in PHP. Now suppose you want to see the browser related information, so just comment this, otherwise it will redirect on another page and it will not display. Now here you just define one variable, $b is equal to $_server. Okay, then in which you have to write HTTP user agent. It will give you the hint. Otherwise, you can type like this way also. Then echo, what you have to display? You have to display your user agent is $b. Got it? Now just execute this practical. Okay, so it is giving you the result like this. Your user agent is Mozilla, a Windows NT, Windows 64-bit. I have 64-bit Windows, that's why. And here it is giving my browser name, that is Chrome. Here, by default, in each and every response, it will give you first Mozilla. Then here, it will provide your browser name. So like this way, you can detect the browser, which browser you are using and which are the features of it. Okay, so summary of this lecture, we have learned about the PHP function. In PHP function, we have learned about the simple function. You can pass the argument, you can pass multiple argument, you can also pass the default argument, and how we are able to return the value in the function. Then we have seen the browser control and browser detection. Browser control, that means you can redirect the page in PHP, you can redirect in the local file also, you can redirect in any particular live website also. Then we have seen the browser detection, that you can see the features about your browser. Okay, so this is all about this lecture. A remaining topic we will cover in the next lecture. Thank you for watching. We will meet in the next lecture with new topic. Thank you.